സിംഗപ്പൂർ ചോയ്സ് സമർപ്പിക്കുന്നത് ഹൗസ് ബ്രാൻഡ് തനതായ സ്വാദിന്റെ സംതൃപ്തി പവേർഡ് ബൈ ഓൾ ഇന്ത്യ സൂപ്പർ മാർട്ട് സിംഗപ്പൂർ ഹോൾസെയിൽ പ്രൈസ് അറ്റ് റീറ്റെയിൽ മാർട്ട് കോ സ്പോൺസേഡ് ബൈ തിരുമലാഗി ദ ട്രസ്റ്റഡ് ടേസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് കൗഗി
എല്ലാവർക്കും സിംഗപ്പൂർ ചോയ്സിലേക്ക് സ്വാഗതം. എല്ലാ ആഴ്ചയും സിംഗപ്പൂരിലെ മനോഹരമായ വിശേഷങ്ങളാണ് ഞാൻ നിങ്ങളുമായിട്ട് പങ്കുവയ്ക്കാറ്. ഇന്നും നമുക്ക് കുറേ അധികം ടാലൻറ്റഡ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള കുറച്ച് ആൾക്കാരും മനോഹരമായ കുറച്ച് കാഴ്ചകളും ഒക്കെ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് വേണ്ടി വെയിറ്റിംഗ് ആണ്. നമുക്ക് ഓരോന്നായിട്ട് കാണാം.
നമസ്കാരം, വെൽക്കം ടു സിംഗപ്പൂർ ചോയ്സ്. ഇഫ് യു വാണ്ട് ടു റീഡ് എ ബുക്ക് ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ് ഹാസ് നോട്ട് ബീൻ റിട്ടേൺ യെറ്റ്, ദൻ യു മസ്റ്റ് റൈറ്റ് ഇറ്റ്, said by Toni Morrison, a famous American author. This statement very much matches to our guest today. We have Anita Devi Pillai, the author of From Kerala to Singapore, Voices of Malayali Community, which has been launched in February 11, 2017. Welcome back to the show.
Namaskar.
Namaskaram. So before we go into the details of your book, can you share with us some of your background?
Sure. I'm third or fourth generation Singapore Malayali, depending on which side of the family you're looking at. Muthuchi was just 3 years old when she arrived in Malaya, and she never went back, you know. And on Acha's side, Acha's Acha came to Singapore. So both my parents were born here, in Malaya and in Singapore. Okay. So been here, my family's been here for 3-4 generations at least.
So ma'am, can you share a few more details about your book launch?
Sure. The book was published in late December 2016, early January 2017. Okay. And it was launched on February 11, 2017. It was hosted by Singapore Indian Association and Singapore Malayali Association.
Okay.
The guest of honor is Professor Tomiko, of course, Ambassador Kesa Ubani, Ambassador Gopinath Pillai, Mr. Vishwa Sadasivan, Mr. Jayadev Funithan, and several other diplomats as well as academics and industry and people from the Malayali community. Actually, they were the VIPs.
Okay. Yeah. This seems to be a very unique subject, unique project actually. So what motivates you to write this, or why do you embark based on this subject?
When I first started, I became interested in the topic when I embarked on my master's thesis. Right, and that was way back in 2002, perhaps.
Okay.
Way back in 2001, 2002. And I was primarily looking at language shift. You know, the Malayali community was going through a language shift, so I was primarily looking at that. And then I realized there was very little documentation on the history of Malayalis in Singapore. For instance, when did they come? I mean, not just historical documents, but historians had recorded that the majority of Malayalis came in 1930s and 1940s. But when I spoke to people in the community, they would tell me, no, not at all. Enda Muthishan on the 1906, 1905. And it didn't just resonate because we didn't seem to have a document or an authoritative book that I could go to. At the end of the day, no one seemed really, everyone was interested, the community was interested, but we are a minority within a minority, you know.
Yes.
So there was very little documentation, and that's what got me interested. Of course, it took me several years after that to get started on the project. I embarked on my PhD and ended it in 2011. And right after it, I started on this project. It's my dream project, I would say. And it's been a long journey. I mean, it's not that there are no documents, but there's no single place or no one has gathered it all together and made sense of the Singapore Malayali community or Singapore Malayali story, for that matter. And that's what I wanted to do.
So sounds like a very tedious task for you to collect the data. The three informations around 100 years back, the people who covered in the featured in the book is actually around 100 years back. So engana itre data is collected, how do you go and approach people, how do you find the data?
Two-pronged approach. Firstly, what I did was I went through the statistics report. So the earliest statistics I got that we had was 1911. Because, you know, Singapore was part of the Indian colony. We never had records. And when people migrate from India to Singapore, there's no need to document them. They were not foreigners.
Yes.
Right? So the records on 1911, there were thousands of Malayalis in Singapore then. And very few women, like a handful of women. That itself was quite a fascinating story. And from then on, I was able to get statistics. So that was the first thing. The second stage was I sat for days, I probably sat for years, looking, poring through old newspaper articles and old documents, old, anything old that I could get hold of, anything that was documented, anywhere where Malayalam, Malayali was mentioned, Kerala was mentioned in Singapore papers. And I looked through. So those were my first basis, and that really formed the basis of my introduction. Okay. And the next stage was tracking down the people who were mentioned in these documents, okay, right, and archives. And so I listened to hundreds of hours of audio tapes of the community and others as well. And then I started talking to people. Yeah. One thing was, quite a few of them had left. Quite a few of these families who were mentioned in the early years had left Singapore or had migrated. So that was the first stage. And then I would hear a story from someone, and then I would then ask for the lead, and I would go to the next house. And that went on for years. I mean, there were, you know, I featured more than 100 interviewees, either as part of the main narrative or the introduction in the book. But we certainly did more than 130 interviews. Yeah.
Okay, that's quite long, I think. So, even namale previously, a couple of years back, when man came for Singapore a choice, this project ne kurche already discussed cheyidundarun. So I think, how long did you take to complete this project? I mean,
data collection
or including the printing of this?
The research, the library research, I had started quite early, at least 2011. The conceptualization was done way earlier. You know, actually, I don't know the exact starting point. It was always my dream project. It was always part of me.
Okay.
I just knew I had to write it. I can't pinpoint the date, but okay, certainly after Singapore Choice, after I spoke to Singapore Choice, I distinctly remember at that point in time, I'd already started the interviews.
Okay.
And and I would only get the weekends to interview. You know, I work full time. I teach at the university. I'm a lecturer at the university. So I have like 2 days in a weekend. And at max, I can't go in and do the interview and run out, right?
Yeah,
so I would sit with all the amachis and the, you know, the aunties and uncles, and I'll talk to them. And then I'll be interviewing. The interviews generally took more than 2 hours. എന്നിട്ട് ഒരു ചായയൊക്കെ കുടിച്ചിട്ട് എന്നിട്ട് ഇന്റർവ്യൂ കണ്ടിന്യൂ എന്തായാലും നിൽക്കു നിൽക്കു ഇപ്പോഴോ ഓർമ്മ വന്ന് കുറേ പറയും. എന്നിട്ട് ദ സ്റ്റോറീസ് ഓഫ് ഫാസിനേറ്റിംഗ്, ദേർസ് നോ വേ ഐ വാസ് ഗോയിങ് ടു സ്റ്റോപ്പ് ദ റെക്കോർഡേഴ്സ്, ഐ വിൽ ബി ലിസണിംഗ് ടു ദം. പിന്നെ ഫോട്ടോസ് ഉണ്ടോ, എന്തെങ്കിലും പഴയത് എന്തെങ്കിലും ഉണ്ടോ പറയുമ്പോൾ ഉണ്ട്, പക്ഷെ എൻ്റെ കട്ടിലിൻ്റെ അടിയിലായിരിക്കും, ക്യാബിനറ്റ് സ്റ്റോർ റൂമിലായിരിക്കും. ഇറ്റ്സ് ഓക്കെ, ലെറ്റ് മീ ട്രൈ. സോ ഐ വിൽ ഗോ ആൻഡ് പുൾ തിങ്സ് ഔട്ട് ആൻഡ് ഐ വിൽ ബി സിറ്റിംഗ് ത്രൂ ഇറ്റ്. ഫോട്ടോസ് ഒക്കെ കാണുമ്പോൾ പിന്നെയും കഥയൊക്കെ പറയാൻ തുടങ്ങും. അങ്ങനെ പതുക്കെ ഇറ്റ് ടുക്ക് ഇയേഴ്സ് ടു ഫിനിഷ് ഇറ്റ്.
I think due to the uniqueness of this project, I think ma'am nangana or attention, because you know you already came into interviews, you know you're featuring in certain places because of this project, even before printing it, right? So that is the uniqueness of this project. So that's quite very good way to do it. And so namali ipo research ne kurichu paranjappo, you have met many and many of people. So did you find any interesting research, interesting findings or interesting people which you would like to share with us?
Where do I start? Interesting people, they were all fascinating.
Okay.
You know, if my publisher hadn't said, enough, stop writing, it's 340 pages, I would have continued.
Oh, okay.
Maybe 1 or 2 years, there's the story. I don't know how to put a full stop to it. I mean, the story doesn't end, right? Certainly, the evolution of the Singapore Malayali community, the changes, you know, the move away from the identification of the Tharavats, the matrilineal system, or the pseudo-matrilineal system, as I found amongst the migrant Singapore Malayali community. All of that, it's a coherent story. I've painted a coherent story. But individually, the individual stories are fascinating by itself. So the interviewees, they were all interesting, of course. Now, the story of the Singapore Malayali on its own, for instance, right, when Singapore had its, after Singapore gained its independence and it had its first definitive series of stamps, so which means that Singapore is publishing the first set of stamps in a theme.
Okay.
It was about masks, dance, it was about masks and dance.
Okay.
So there were 2 stamps for Malays, 2 stamps for Indians, 2 stamps for Chinese, angane, right? But the 2 stamps for Indians, and it just hit me one day when I was looking through it, the mask was a Kathakali mask.
Okay.
the dancer was Mrs. Shanta Bhaskaran, a cultural medallion winner. She's a Malayali.
Okay.
So we were very small in numbers. I mentioned we were a minority within a minority. We still are. But certainly, we must have been noticed. Certainly, mm-hmm. we made our mark. And it's a theme that a lot of people have observed. And from an ethnic perspective, I interviewed people from outside the community as well. Like, you know, our former president, S.R. Nathan, sir, and Professor Rajesh Rai and all. And one common theme that kept coming up was we were always disproportionately represented mm-hmm. in politics and in other circles, in the media and all. So we were quite, we did stand out, I guess, in this small little country.
House Brand, കഴിഞ്ഞ 60 വർഷമായി സിംഗപ്പൂരിന്റെ തനത് രുചിക്കൂട്ടുകൾക്കും സ്വാദിനും ഒപ്പമാണ്. ഞങ്ങളുടെ ഓരോ ഉൽപ്പന്നങ്ങളുടെയും വാസനയും ഗുണമേന്മയും നഷ്ടപ്പെടാതിരിക്കാൻ ക്രയോജനിക് സാങ്കേതികവിദ്യ ഉപയോഗിച്ച് ഞങ്ങളുടെ തന്നെ ഫാക്ടറിയിൽ തയ്യാറാക്കി പാക്ക് ചെയ്യുന്നു. ഹൗസ് ബ്രാൻഡ്, തനത് സ്വാദിന്റെ സംതൃപ്തി.
All India Supermart. Enjoy the sprawling one-stop shopping experience in 4 floors. The premier All India Supermart offers wide range and great varieties of consumer products. Groceries to fresh vegetables, chocolates, lifestyle products, fashion wear, pharmacy and beauty. All India Supermart's futuristic self-service kiosk is a highlight for groceries. All India Supermart, 41 Norris Road, Singapore.
തിരുമല്ല നെയ് ശർക്കര പായസത്തിന് സ്ട്രോങ് സപ്പോർട്ട്, നെയ്ദോശയ്ക്ക് സൂപ്പർ സപ്പോർട്ട്, ഗുലാബ് ജാമിന് ക്ലോസ് ഫ്രണ്ട്. വീട്ടിലും വിരുന്നിലും ഏറ്റവും അടുത്ത സുഹൃത്ത് തിരുമല്ല നെയ്.
Our priceless possession, Ayurveda. At Ananta Ayurveda, relax and detoxify. Unwind and rejuvenate your mind and body from an array of treatments and massage therapies. Get expert advice for specific ailments, spinal and muscular conditions. Ananta Ayurvedic Healthcare, Buffalo Road and Yishun Street, 71, Singapore. Call 6396-4494. Ananta Ayurveda. Reliving a treasured past.
So you must have experienced a huge life, huge number of people life, you know, you have gone through stages of that. So the data might be very less, but you might be experienced, you know, their lives completely because of stories you heard. So that was a very good information, and you know, how to meet, how to discuss people and how to gather the information. So what are the most memorable moments when you meet them? You know, do you have any moments which you can't forget it, or you always keep close to your heart?
The project itself is close to my heart, but and there were many good moments, but I think if I close my eyes and I think about the whole project, I think the best was when the book was launched and it went into their hands, and there was one auntie who came and put her hand on my head. It's an anna irunnu mole, and you know, and it was like a blessing. Thank you nokka paranju, and I didn't mean it like that. It was my dream project, and there were quite a few of these uncles and aunties who blessed me, especially this one auntie. I'll never forget the way what she said. And then there were a couple of people who called up and said, we know a lot about the Singapore Malayali community. I mean, remember, we are a very young country as well.
Correct.
So it's, and the families know each other. We are a very small community, very tight-knit community in Singapore. And despite that, there were things that I had written that they said that they were not aware of. Like, for instance, election, in the early years, election officers, they were looking for people who spoke in Malayalam. It's not one of our official languages, you know.
Yeah.
There was a strike notice in the 50s. There was English, Chinese, Malay, and Malayalam.
Mm-hmm.
There were quite a few of these little nuggets of information that I think they had not realized or noticed, or, you know. And they told me that they appreciated that. And I think that was the best moment,
okay.
You know, bringing the information out to the community. I think that beats it.
Yeah, that's nice. So when we talk about the good moments, I'm sure that there must be some difficulties as well. So endarana buddhimuttukal ingenoru project execute cheythu varana, it's a long way or long and a tedious task. Endengilum difficulties
kore undarana. For one, there was a lot of data to be collected, quite a lot of people to talk to, because you can't talk to 50 people or less and try to tell the story. You needed at least 100 families to be interviewed. Okay. It was a long journey just collecting the data. But interview Pomba, it wouldn't just be one interview. I'll have to do a follow-up interview. And when I come back and I start writing the story, I'll start thinking, oh, that part I forgot to ask, but that part seems important to the, you know, to what they're telling me. So I have to go back to them for the interview. Then we did photographs, you know. Mm-hmm. I wanted to capture them as they are now for our record purposes. So there was another visit, and that was followed by, I did family trees as well to show the changes. So family trees are organic. They change. They change as in people are added, etc. So managing that, spelling of names, Tharavat names, when was the first person who came in your family, where did they come from, how did they arrive, all those details. There's a massive amount of data to be collected. That was the biggest challenge in this project, I think. And that's what took so long as well.
That was a big information or big collection of information you shared. Are you going to work on any of the series of this book, or do you have any other dream project you're going to start soon?
Already started work on two projects.
Not the series of this book?
Not a series of this book. Because, you know, it really depends on what this book means to you as a reader. If you pick it up and you read the stories, and you can read the stories independently of thinking about what it means collectively, then it's a collection of stories. But if you look at what is it telling you, if you look at the introduction, the academic introduction, where I trace and I analyze the evolution of Malayali who came from Kerala to Singapore, right? So if you only looked at the voices part, perhaps another book of story of voices. But from Kerala to Singapore, I think it'll take another 50 years for the new migrants, because we've got a huge influx of migrants who've arrived in Singapore, to see whether they'll stay, and for those who stay, what is their story going to be?
Okay.
Acha apparokka naan 50 years parayumba naan kaanulla
appo kore projects kuda kadiyum dream projects, right?
So my students, hopefully someone will take it up.
Appo mapne it actually oru big experience aanu your project embark cheyadengil. Do you have any suggestions for those people who is actually, you know, looking for embarking on similar projects?
Oh, absolutely. Start on something that you really like. You know, you must be passionate about something, because at 3 a.m., at 4 a.m., when you're exhausted and you know you've got to wake up in 2 hours' time to get to work, to be able to write, you really need to be passionate about something. It must mean something to you. Writing must come from your heart. And that, I think, is quite important. So start on something you're passionate about. Start on something that you want to know more about, because when I was going through the newspaper articles, why did they change the name? Why did Kerala Association change the name to Malayali Association? Who was it? Which year was it? Why is there a gap in the date? No, I can't sleep. It's not that I tell myself I'm going to sleep at 3 o'clock. I'll be awake all through the night, and then 6 a.m. and the alarm rings and my dad calls me and says, that's the first thing. So I think something you're passionate about, something that's from your heart, you will get it done. That's the first thing. Secondly, ask questions. Keep asking lots of questions. It's okay if people get a little irritated with you, because they'll appreciate it later.
Okay.
You know, I think that's quite important.
Sure.
And as much as possible, be thorough. Ask people to read your work. Get as much feedback as you can. That would be something I tell my students. That's something I would tell any fellow researcher.
Okay. So you were just telling about you started on some of the projects, right? Adine kurichu endengil onnu parayamo.
Rendu projects start cheyittundu. One of it relates to the Malayalis, the other is related to my work, pedagogy work. Malayali project, I've started researching on Malayali writers and Malayalam writing in Singapore.
Okay.
Because one thing I realized as I was working on this was that there were quite a lot of people, Mr. M.K. Basi, Mr. N.C. Katil, Vilasani, the writer Vilasani with Mr. Menon, a lot of writers. We seem to have produced a lot of writers in Singapore. Either they were writing in Malayalam or they were writing in English, and even Tamil, you know, for that matter. I touched on it, I looked at, I mean, I analyzed it, and they talked about it, but I want to go into greater depth. What was the motivating factor? What got them writing? I mean, after all, when they came in the early years, mm-hmm. they did not have access mm-hmm. to Malayalam language as much as they do now. Ipprele internet omission and okay vanna then we've all got access to Malayalam language, you Correct. Know apurakon we I mm-hmm. don't think they had access mm-hmm. so that's my next project.
Okay, that's cool. So I just hope your new project will also get so much of attention and so much success like this.
Thank you.
ഹൗസ് ബ്രാൻഡ് കഴിഞ്ഞ 60 വർഷമായി സിംഗപ്പൂരിൻ്റെ തനത് രുചിക്കൂട്ടുകൾക്കും സ്വാദിനും ഒപ്പമാണ്. ഞങ്ങളുടെ ഓരോ ഉൽപ്പന്നങ്ങളുടെയും വാസനയും ഗുണമേന്മയും നഷ്ടപ്പെടാതിരിക്കാൻ ക്രയോജനിക് സാങ്കേതികവിദ്യ ഉപയോഗിച്ച് ഞങ്ങളുടെ തന്നെ ഫാക്ടറിയിൽ തയ്യാറാക്കി പാക്ക് ചെയ്യുന്നു. ഹൗസ് ബ്രാൻഡ്, തനത് സ്വാദിൻ്റെ സംതൃപ്തി.
QBB Pure Ghee for cooking, baking and barbecue. Superior taste in so many ways. QBB Pure Ghee.
Winsys Beauty. Pamper yourself in true luxury, most comforting, home-alike environment. Relax in the scented ambience with our signature custom-made facials from carefully hand-picked organic products. Look your best effortlessly with Winsys painless 5-minute threading. Get rated by our highly qualified staff who will attend you with care and diligence. Winsys Beauty. Feel beautiful more than you already are. Number 3 Norris Road, Little India, Singapore.
The book keeper launch at a couple of months, right? How is the reaction so far? I mean, you're getting any calls, any visitors, any surprising guest?
I've received inquiries from overseas, primarily from UK, US. Okay. A lot of Malayalis migrated to the UK from Singapore in those days. And there was this one family who came from Sweden, actually two, three families contacted me, where they have roots in Kerala. So it's one of them, one partner is a Malayali and the other isn't. So there's a Swedish family, very sweet Swedish family, right?
That's nice.
The wife is a Malayali and mm-hmm. she's from Singapore, and the husband's Swedish. And they came and they called and they said, we want to talk to you, we want to meet you. We want to buy this book as a gift for all our children and grandchildren mm-hmm, so that they will find out about the Malayali culture, and they will understand what it was like to be, or what it is like to be a Singapore Malayali, mm-hmm. you know, which is quite different from being a Malayali from Kerala. I thought that was quite interesting. Yeah. You know, when you write, you don't think beyond the book. You just get it done. I was writing and writing and writing. I saw this book, mm-hmm. but that's all I saw.
So that was quite a good appreciation coming from all over the world, I think.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah, that's a very good work. Then when I ask about that, you must be having some inspiration, right, on writing. Maybe I can ask about writing. Who is your inspiration on writing?
My mom.
Okay.
Amma is a writer. Amma writes in Tamil. She's published a lot. She's award-winning. Her books are used in the university in India as well. But she's Tamil, Amma. Because Amma was born and raised in Malaysia, she attended Tamil schools and all. All my memories of Amma, she is writing in some corner of the house, right? That's all her focus is. When she's in the kitchen, she's reading not books on recipes, right? She's reading her books. She's writing, so she just gets everything done and she quickly goes off to write. And I grew up watching that. And I always used to wonder, Amma ke ingane adokka ideas okka varunu. And I was also always afraid, because if I argue with her, the next week I'll be in a story, usually a naughty girl in the story. Amma is always my inspiration.
So you're getting some ideas from her, or I mean, how do you get your ideas for choosing a subject?
I don't know.
Maybe you're getting some references from your Amma.
From Amma. Yeah. I don't know.
For the new writers who is actually looking for, you know, aspiring writers, so do you have any tips to give to them? You know, any, you know, there are a lot of traps in this, you know, writing, you know, some stuck up in middle of writing and all. So do you have something for them, some information, some guidelines for them, so that it will be helpful for them?
I think you must tell yourself, write every day.
Okay.
Give yourself a specific time and set that time aside. and write every day. You don't have to write for hours.
Mm-hmm.
If you find yourself getting lost in your writing, fantastic. But even if you have no motivation, be at your computer, just sit there. Tell yourself from this time to this time, switch off your phone, no WhatsApp, shut everything off. I write after my son goes to sleep.
Oh, okay.
So I get him to bed 10, 10:30, 11. I'm like, orangamone. I do exactly what my mom did. Orangamone. Then I start writing about 11, 11:30. And I tell myself I will stop at 2 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
I set the alarm. I think it's very important. First and foremost, have a specific time.
Okay.
Have a specific space. And have a ritual, I think. I have to have my coffee. I have to check my Facebook account. I have to read the papers. Then I feel like I've done everything else. Then I have nothing else to do but write. Then I start writing. So have a ritual, I think. That helps me. I think reading certainly takes you at a different world that visuals can't.
Correct.
And I think that's quite important.
So that was a very good information for our upcoming writers. Hope that will be helpful for them. Appol kaanunavarkellam ee or informations vach they will start working on it and they will choose specific unique topics, projects, and then try to be like you then. Okay, so that is a lot of information about this book. Ipo nammada viewers aarkengil ee book vaanganannundengil where can they find it?
In Singapore, it's available at Kinokuniya, Times, Singapore Indian Association, as well as it will be on Amazon by July
okay.
this year.
Mm-hmm. That's good. So people can go and buy it directly. But if anyone who is not in Singapore, it's, from outside Singapore, how they get it?
How can they get it? Well, it'll be available on Amazon soon.
Okay, fine.
Yeah.
A great book should leave with many experiences, but towards the end, little bit exhausted. But you will live several life while reading it. Hope you will get the same experience reading this book. So thank you, ma'am, for your time and giving us a lot of information about this book from Kerala to Singapore. Namaskaram.
Namaskaram.
Singapore Choice. Samarpichathu House Brand Tanadaya Sodinte Samthrupthi. Powered by All India Supermart Singapore. Wholesale price at Retail Mart. Co-sponsored by Tirumalagi, the trusted taste of cow ghee.